Just take a message.
Certainly.
And please, don't be too long. I want to keep the lines clear.
Capo residence.
I'd like to talk to Sophia Capo, please. This is Steve Bassett calling. I'm with the district attorney's office.
I'm sorry, but Mrs. Capo can't come to the phone right now. I'll take a message.
Christy, is that you?
Well, I'll be darned, it really is. You sure do get around.
Lockridge's, Capo's? You're traveling in fast company these days, kiddo. Congratulations.
Well, tell Mrs. Capel you called.
Who was it?
It was my stepfather, Steve. He wanted to talk to Mrs. Capel.
Eugenia?
No, Sophia.
Telephone call for me.
Yeah, I didn't think he'd want to take it right now. His name is Steve Bassett, and he's with the district attorney's office.
Well, I wonder what that's all about.
I don't know, but I bet it's very important, and I think I should call him back.
I'm sorry, I didn't know. No, it's all right, don't worry about it.
Won't you please forgive me?
I would have never tried to hurt you. I just needed someone to hold me, to fill the void while you were gone, to fill the space of emptiness. I'm only human, of flesh and blood I'm made. Human, born to make mistakes.
Danny, this necklace is just waiting to be fished out by you.
I've been wondering if I'm really cut out for the priesthood, and the more I think about it, the more confident I feel that I am.
Danny, come on, it's tickling me. You're really gonna have to hunt for it now.
I mean, to be a priest, you really have to be able to resist anything, and I think I can do that.
Come on, Danny, it's tickling me.
I think I'll go for my vows.
Where are you going?
The closest church.
Come back here. I need some help.
I've been so good all night. I don't want to blow it now.
Danny, you can't be serious. Come on, aren't you gonna help me fish it out? It's a neat idea.
You're one of those women that like to keep us off track. Put rings in our noses so you can lead us around.
What?
Like Lakin has a ring through Ted's nose.
Danny, that's not true.
Yeah, it is. Lakin is all Ted can think about. He's a goner. I lost my best friend to a girl.
Danny, don't be stupid.
I never took anything from that house that I didn't bring back.
Then give me back the bracelet. Come on, it's not yours.
What is mine? Tell me exactly what do I own? Will somebody tell me that? Don't touch me, Ted.
Just...
Give it to me. It's not yours, it's mine.
Christy, just calm down, all right? It is my bracelet.
No, it's not.
Christy, would you just listen to yourself? Now, I bought this bracelet for Lakin.
You don't care about her.
Christy, I told you I love her.
No, it doesn't make sense. You can't love her. You can't. I'm good to you. Is there something so wrong with me that everyone sees it no matter what I do?
Of course not.
I'm better. I'm stronger. I'm smarter. I'm anything you want me to be. Okay, fine. No, I don't have $1 million to grow up with perfect teeth and perfect skin. Who cares? Why can't anybody want me? Why do I always have to go when everyone else gets to stay?
You don't have to go.
Yes, I do.
Christy, I wish you wouldn't.
Oh, stop it.
Come on, lady, dry your eyes. Wipe your tears. Never like to see you cry.
Won't you please forgive me?
I would have never tried to hurt you.
Hey, Christy, way to go.
8. I'm sorry, I have some bad news.
What?
What's about yesterday?
What about yesterday? I don't understand.
There were witnesses.
Witnesses?
There are two people who saw you with the gun.
Who? I don't understand. Does it matter anyway? I mean, are you mistaken?
Well, it matters a great deal. You had no permit to carry the gun. There very definitely could be a problem. I'm here to help.
It's obvious that you don't trust Ted, or you wouldn't be coming to me playing games, trying to find out if he's lying or not. I don't think that anybody wants to be lying, Chrissy. Just forget it, never mind.
Wait.
What? Ted needs you. He needs you to believe in him right now. If I didn't believe in him, I wouldn't be here trying to help him. I was trying to help you too, but you make it impossible.
Lakin, wait. I do need to see Ted. Couldn't you just set it up somehow? I don't think that we'll be able to get through this if you don't. I'll make the arrangements.
You're the one who said we have to be always thinking about our careers day and night. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a wonderful game of solitaire I'd like to finish.
Are you telling me you don't have time for girls?
Oh, not if I want a career in show business. I've got to be obsessed.
Oh, you're obsessed, all right. You're a loony.
I'm not. I'm just realistic. I know what I want. No women. I don't want to be like Ted. Just a career for me. Hey, look at that. I got a 10. It's just what I needed, too, right there.
Can't have both? What about Warren Beatty?
Oh, Warren Beatty, come on. Use him and lose him, that's all publicity. His career always comes first.
Maybe.
You're ambitious, so am I. So you should know first off that romance would just foul things up for me.
You want something to drink? It's so hot tonight.
No thanks.
You know what?
What?
I think you're right.
Yeah?
Absolutely.
That's great. Look at that. I got a king. That's fantastic.
You warm too?
Kind of.
Mm-hmm.
I admire you, Danny. You're strong. Man of principle. I admire a man with ambition and willpower. Willing to make sacrifices. I would never get in the way of your ambition. Never. Excuse me, I got a couple things I want to do tonight.
Okay, wait a second. Come back here. Where do you think you're...